play with us a bit. The ones we saw earlier, that big colourful one, that's a golden orb spider. They're not venomous, so not to us humans at least. Hey. Now if you're a little insect, then she's very dangerous. But to us humans, you know, if you read the books on spiders, they actually say the way to collect that spider, if you were studying them, is hand to jar. It's one of my favorite little comic things in spider books, is the hand to jar collection. They even give you the same one for baboon spiders, which look a bit like tarantulas. Hey, gorgeous. See if she gives us another ear flap or head shake just now. Oh, amazing. Fantastic, she's right here next to us. Oh, she's beautiful. Hey? You're curious about us just like we are about you. You can see how she's holding the ears high up. But again, she's not feeling threatened or she's not being aggressive at all. This is pure curiosity. The ears being high up like that is also often how they hold them when they listen to other sounds going on. There, she's digging out something. Let's see if she actually brings something out. Often they pretend to be doing something to sort of disguise her basic need or reason for being. Oh, there she's got it. Look at that. Almost like a potato. In this case, she got some good food there as well. Actually hear it chewing that. Good food. But you know, they're still learning. Like I've mentioned, some techniques in terms of breaking branches or stripping bark and even usage of trunk and tusks, elephants can develop well into their 20s still. Get better at it. Hello. Okay. Well, she's asking us again what's going on. All right. Making a bit more noise there. But she's relaxed. She's digging food again. She was messing around with us, intimidating us a bit, but not in a worried way, more in just a, like something to do way. Anyway, she's asking that sound she's making there. She's digging out another bit of food again. That sound that you heard earlier, Terry was asking if that's a way of communicating with us. She wasn't actually making that sound. Even though elephants do often make that sound, it's just one of my favorite sounds to make. And whenever I'm around elephants, especially if we're going to see them a lot over the next while, I always hope that we do. Typically they move through here, but then it does give them a sound, apart from the vehicle being quite specific, also a sound that they could recognize. And if it's an elephant that's exposed to that quite often, like Wonky was, then it's something that's familiar to them as well. And over time I've gotten more used to and more consistent with being able to produce a similar sound. Now you can hear it with elephants that sound very, very similar. So I've never had a negative response to it. So it's just a little introduction. There she's got another. It's not a potato, but it's similar to a potato. It's not something we can eat, but Chang'an people do make a drink from that bulb. Elephants obviously find quite a good snack this time of year. I was thinking of a name for her because, like I said, I have seen her before and I couldn't quite get the name. And Roy, do you, if I said the name Finn, would you get it? Typically, I always try and name elephants to something that partakes to the animal.
Because of the shape of the notch in or the hole in the ears, a perfect shark fin sort of shape. Is that right?
Exactly.
I was thinking maybe Valerie.
She's right here next to us with the big V.
Is the V, but that's...
Look at her, guys. She's right here. Hello. There's the fin. You're amazing.
It's gorgeous.
Camera shy. She's still getting used to photographs, sorry. it's interesting there. It didn't scare her, but it's just the sound that she was a bit like, hey, I don't want to be photographed, I'm shy. Look, she's hiding behind the bush there. She'll get used to it. They all do in the end, Lesion. Just have cameras around all the time and you'll get comfortable with it. Guys, it's an amazing elephant. I think the name Finn, like Roy said there, it's a nice, that V shape in the ear. And when naming elephants, it's always nice to try and name it relative to something on the animal that you could easily recognize in future. In this case, we don't have to remember too hard. We should be able to remember that again. And also, in advance, thank you very much for those of you that will help me ID her again in future. I know many of you capture images and are very good at helping me remember some of the things. But I think Finn here works well for us. And she's an amazing elephant. She was, I don't know how close she was there, Rory. She was right here next to us, coming to have a look at
the 50 centimeters from the side of the vehicle.
Foot or two.